Welcome to this video. In this video, we will learn another test design technique, use case testing. First, we will understand what is a use case, then we'll see a sample use case, and then write test cases for that use case. So let us get started. First of all, what is a use case? Well, a use case is a list of steps to achieve a particular goal in the system under test. Now, these steps in the use case define the interactions between the actor and the system. Now, what is an actor? The actor can be a user, the actor can be another system, or the actor can be elapsed time. The use case captures the functional requirements or features of the system. Another thing the use case does is it defines the outcomes of errors during system use. For example, it may throw an error message or it may end the use case with a failure. The use case has two parts. It has the main scenarios and the optional exceptional scenarios. A scenario is nothing but a workflow or a sequence of events. So let us see an example use case. Now, this is a use case for the cash withdrawal from an ATM system. So we have the use case name, cash withdrawal, and there are a couple of actors. The first actor is a customer who is going to be using the ATM system to withdraw cash. And there is a bank actor, which is another system with which the ATM system communicates. So this use case describes how the customer uses the ATM system to withdraw cash from his or her bank account. A use case can have preconditions which have to be true before the use case is triggered. So there are a couple of preconditions here. First, the ATM system is online. That means it is able to communicate with the bank. And second precondition is that it has sufficient cash available. So we have the main scenario or the normal workflow. What this means is that this is where the actor can interact with the system and there are going to be no errors. So there is going to be expected output. So the first step in the normal workflow is the customer will insert their debit card and then it is kind of a dialogue between the customer and the system. The system will prompt for the PIN. Then the customer will enter the PIN. The system will display the option to withdraw cash and the customer is going to select that option. Then the system will prompt for an amount to be withdrawn. The customer will enter the amount. Then the system will submit the amount to the bank for approval and the bank will confirm the transaction that it is okay, because this is a normal workflow. Then the system will dispense the cash amount in the tray and the system will return the card and the use case ends with a success. So this is a normal workflow. Apart from the normal workflow, the use case can have alternate workflows also. So let us see those alternate workflows. So first alternate workflow is that what happens if the PIN is invalid? Now, if we see step number 3, where the customer enters a PIN. Now, the system has the step number 4, which says that the system will display the option to withdraw the cash. Now, if the customer entered the invalid PIN instead of 4, the system is going to execute step 4A. Which means there are going to be some other steps. The first, what it will do is it will return the card and then the use case ends with a failure. So after step number 3, it is possible that instead of going to step number 4, it directly comes to the system will return the card and the use case ends with a failure. So this is an alternate workflow which happens if the customer enters an invalid PIN. Now there is another alternate workflow. What if the amount is invalid? So as you can see, the customer will enter an amount in step number 7 in the normal workflow, But what if they entered an invalid amount? In that case, the system will display an error message and prompt for another amount, and the use case resumes at step 7. So step 7 is where the customer enters a valid amount. So like that, we can have other alternate workflows also. So for example, in step number 9, the bank confirms the transaction. Now it may happen that the bank denies the transaction. So if the bank declines the transaction, then what is going to happen is, instead of step number 10, which is the system will dispense the cash amount, etc., what the system does is the system will return the card and the use case ends with a failure. There is another possibility that the customer selects the option to cancel. Now this can happen at many places within the normal workflow. It can happen at step 3, step 5 and step 7. So in step 3, the customer enters the PIN, but instead of entering the PIN, they may choose to cancel. In step 5, the customer will enter the option to withdraw cash, but instead of selecting the option to withdraw cash, they may choose to cancel the entire transaction. And similarly, in step number 7, the customer will enter an amount, but instead of that, they may choose to cancel the transaction. So this is another alternate workflow. In that case, what is going to happen is that the system will return the card and the use case ends. We can have additional business rules also in the use case. So here an additional business rule is that the system will dispense a maximum amount of $100 in a single transaction. And the post condition, just as we have preconditions, we may have post conditions also in the use case. So here there is a single post condition: the customer will receive their cash amount. So in use case testing, first we have to review the use case. So because use case is capturing the functional requirements of the system, so we have to review the use case to see whether the requirements are complete, correct, unambiguous, and so on. So the first thing we can do is we can test whether the use case is atomic or not. Now this particular use case is related to cash withdrawal, but the ATM system is able to perform other functionality also, like check balance or deposit cash. So none of the normal workflow or the alternate workflows have to deal with any other functionality like viewing the balance or depositing cash. It has to be totally related to cash withdrawal functionality only. Next, what we can review is whether the normal workflow is complete. So for example, here the customer just enters the PIN and enters the option to withdraw the cash and enters an amount. So let us say that based on your knowledge of the ATM system, there may be an additional option to select the language, like the customer wants to use the ATM system in English language or in Spanish language. So there may be missing steps in the normal workflow. So such review you can do when you review the use case. Next, we can check whether the alternate workflows are complete or not. One more thing we can review in our use case review is that, is each step testable? Now here in step number 8, it says the system will submit the amount to the bank for approval. Now how are we going to test if the bank has confirmed the transaction or declined the transaction? So that is something which may not be testable. So if it is not testable, it should not appear as part of the use case. So that is how we review the use case. Now once we have reviewed the use case and any review comments have been addressed, etc., we can write the test cases. So in order to write the test cases, so what we can do is we can write test cases to test the normal flow and each alternate flow. We could write a single test case in which we test the normal flow and each alternate flow, but in my opinion that may be unreadable. So I prefer writing test cases, one test case for the normal workflow and one test case each for each of the alternate workflows. So this is how we can test the normal workflow. So this is the test case cash withdrawal normal workflow. So in the test case we have the steps and we have the expected results. So we can write the steps, and the steps you can get from the use case. So for example, the very first step is the customer will insert their debit card. So that becomes the step. And the second step in the use case is the system will prompt for the PIN. That becomes the expected result. So since the use case alternates between the steps performed by the actor and the system, we can put the steps performed by the actor as the steps, and we can put the steps performed by the system as the expected results. So this is the normal workflow. Insert debit card. Expected result is the system will prompt for the PIN. Then enter a valid PIN. The system will display the option to withdraw cash. Select the option to withdraw cash. The system will prompt for an amount. Enter the amount as $100, which is a valid amount, and the system will dispense the cash amount and the system will return the card. So this tests the normal workflow. Now let us see how we can test the alternate workflows also. Now the first alternate workflow is related to the invalid PIN. Now here step one is repeat step one of cash withdrawal one. So cash withdrawal one is this test case. So insert debit card, and here the expected results are not given because they are already present in the previous test case that tests the normal workflow, but enter an invalid PIN. And the expected result here is, again it is coming from the use case, that the system will return the card. So this tests the alternate workflow. Now let us see how we can test the other alternate workflow. What if the amount is invalid? So in the case of invalid amount, what we do is repeat step 1 through 4 of cash withdrawal. So here we already have the steps and expected results listed for the normal workflow. The only difference is that instead of putting a valid amount, we are putting an invalid amount of $101. So $101 violates the additional business requirement, which says that the ATM system can dispense only a maximum of $100 in a single transaction. So the expected result here is coming from the use case. The system will display an error message and prompt for another amount. Next, repeat step 4 of cash withdrawal with another invalid amount, which is $0. So obviously $0 is an invalid amount. So again, the system will display an error message and prompt for another amount. And this time we are going to enter the valid amount of $1, and the use case basically resumes at this point. So the system dispenses the cash amount and returns the card. So this is how we can test the alternate workflow. Now the next alternate workflow is, what happens if the bank declines the transaction? So we can write another test case for that. So here, repeat step 1 through 4 of cash withdrawal with an amount which is more than the account balance. So obviously it is an invalid amount, it cannot be withdrawn. And as per the use case, the system will return the card. Now we have the last alternate workflow, which is to test the cancel option. So here, what we can do is repeat step 1 of cash withdrawal 1. So basically, insert the card and then select the option to cancel, and the system will return the card. Then repeat steps 1 and 2 of cash withdrawal 1, the first test case which tests out the normal workflow. So basically insert the card and enter a valid PIN and then select the option to cancel and the system will return the card. Then repeat steps 1 through 3 of cash withdrawal 1, which means insert the card, enter a valid PIN and select the option to withdraw cash and then select the option to cancel and the system will return the card. Now one other thing we can do in writing test cases for the use case is that we can use test design techniques like boundary value analysis and equivalence partitioning. So here we can see that here we are testing the valid partition because $100 is within the valid partition and we are also testing with $1 which is also in the valid partition and also we are testing the invalid partition because $101 falls in an invalid partition and we are also testing with $0 which falls in another invalid partition and we have used boundary value analysis also. So $100 is the maximum limit that the ATM system can dispense, so we are testing with that. $1 is the minimum amount that the ATM system can dispense and we are testing with that. And also other side of the boundary we are testing with $101 and $0. In use case testing we run the test cases and many testers make the mistake of testing only the normal workflow, so that is not where you may find the defects. It is better to test the normal workflow as well as the alternate workflows. So we have to be careful regarding defects. Maybe there are missing steps in the normal workflow or there is a complete alternate workflow that is not implemented, and also we can get defects on the boundaries and the different equivalence classes. So that is how we do use case testing. I hope you enjoyed this video. So thank you for watching this video and see you in the next video.